how do you know you're a master mechanic? Well, some people say that's how successful you are. How flashy vehicles you drive, flashy signs. I'm gonna tell you that if you need flashy signs to sell your services, you're not a master mechanic. You're a mediocre mechanic. Sorry to say that. You can have signs, you can have a nice car on that. But you see, drive an old 1999 Suzuki Grand Vitara, keep it on the road. On roads like that. Off-roading, most of the time, services these tractors. All my clients book me up in front for a month or more. Some even pay me a month in advance for my services, just to ensure that I do get to them at least once a week to them to repair their vehicles and keep them running. Keep these old tractors apart. I split them alone myself. I don't need helpers to help me. I repair them. I keep my costs low. Don't have all that overhead cost, so my clients are very happy and I'm fully booked. That's how you know you're a master mechanic. I don't need a computer to tell me what to do. Sorry, most mechanics that use computers. I work on brand new vehicles like 2000s upwards that use computers. I repair them as well for my clients. Some of them are the Mercedes, BMWs, all these very expensive luxury cars. I actually, most of the time, I don't need a computer to tell me what's wrong with the vehicle, because most of the time it plugs. Just a bad connector, then those cars has gone to the garage many times back, gets sensors replaced, and then it comes back, same problem, 2 or 3 months, eventually out of warranty, the client comes to me and tells me they can't get it fixed by the workshops. Can I fix it? Because it's costing them a lot of money. So all I do is go and clean up connections, and then that vehicle runs for 2, 3, 4, 5 years still with that exact same sensor that they were replacing at the dealerships every 3 or 4 months. Yeah, master mechanics. If you're a master mechanic, you don't need a computer. That's a parts fitter. You're a parts fitter if you need a computer to tell you how to do your work. I just want to get this off my chest so everybody knows what a master mechanic is. Master mechanic, always fully booked. I don't even get sometimes time for my own vehicle or vehicles, because I have multiple vehicles. This is my work vehicle. I have to keep it up running, because that brings my bread and butter in. But this is a good vehicle, not much breakages, but yeah, I kept it on the road. So yeah, now you know what it takes to be a master mechanic, because people has been asking me how to become a master mechanic. I had lots of mechanics that come to me to try to become a field master mechanic, and they normally pack up. They just last about a week to 3 weeks with me. Then they pack up because they cannot take it to split the tractor alone. They cannot take it to do everything alone. Battle in the field. Make do with the tools you've got, because they're so used to the luxury of a workshop. Yeah. This is my workshop. This is my workshop. So yeah, now it's a bit lengthy video, but yeah, I enjoy the outdoors. I really don't like to work in a workshop in a confined space. Yeah, fresh air, sunshine, sometimes rain. I had to work once in snow, work on very high things like forklifts, container forklifts, mobile cranes. Yeah, I like the outdoors, I don't like the indoors.